give me some of your oil. That is a line that kind of jumps out at me whenever I hear this parable, because it sounds so selfish for the five who had extra, not to give some to the five for whom their lights and lamps went out because they did not have sufficient oil. This is a parable, it's a story. But yet it's a story that, when Jesus tells it, relates to the people of his time, because they're familiar with this kind of ritual. The bride waits for the bridegroom to arrive for the wedding. And she waits in her home. And the bridesmaids wait with her outside. And you never know when the groom's going to show up. This is really just the opposite of what we experience today. We're forever waiting for the bride to arrive. But in this case, in those days, it was the groom who came to the bride's house to take his bride to his house, and there would the wedding take place. And so you never knew when the groom was going to show up. And so they had to wait. But that's not the point of the story. The point of the story is, it seems apparent to the reader, at least on the surface, that those five virgins who were waiting, who had extra oil, were very stingy in not giving oil to those who had none. But that's not really the case, because the oil that they had, they could not give to those bridesmaids whose oil was consumed. And I say that because of what the oil represents. It's not just oil. It's the oil of grace. It's the oil of forgiveness. It's the oil of compassion. It's the oil of generosity. And you can't give that to anyone. It is something that we develop ourselves in our own faith journey with God, imitating the values of the gospel, to assume these kinds of virtues in our own life. The virtue of understanding, the virtue of courage, the virtue of as I said, forgiveness and generosity, and those kinds of good virtues. And you can't give them to somebody else. They have to earn them themselves. They have to develop that part of their own spiritual life themselves. They can certainly be mentored, but they can't be given those things. They have to be developed within the person themselves. And so the oil is very significant in terms of what it represents, because those bridesmaids couldn't give the oil. The point of the parable was that there are just some things that we cannot give to other people, as much as we'd like to. They can't see our perspective on things. They can't perhaps even see things with the eyes of faith, because their faith has been so underdeveloped. And so they lack the ability to be able to embrace the Catholic faith and the teachings of the Church as much as others can. And so that's really, to me, the point of this parable, is to be thankful for the virtue and the gifts that we have. And yes, we can share our emotions and our compassion and our generosity with others. We can't give the source to others. Hopefully they'll learn from the example of others that they too have those gifts latently inside of them that yet have to be developed. Let me just spend a second on St. Augustine. He's such a fantastic saint in our church, and one that's very popular because we have his writings. Even though he was born in the third and fourth century, the 300s, in North Africa, his mother, we celebrated yesterday, was Monica. Monica was born and raised as a Catholic. She married a pagan by the name of Peter, and she had three sons. One of them was Augustine. Augustine was brought up in the family, so to speak, of Christian values, but he was never baptized. And eventually he just gave up his faith entirely and sought other heresies and other sects at the time. Until he finally became aware, touched by a teacher, a mentor by the name of Ambrose at one of the universities. Now, His mother, these 15 to 20 years, has been praying persistently for the conversion of her son. Her husband converted on his deathbed. And finally, after meeting Ambrose, who's now a saint as well, St. Ambrose, he became more and more convinced that the Catholic Church is something that he can embrace and can live. And so he was baptized by Ambrose. And his mother, his saintly mother, was there. And a year before her death, she was able to see the baptism of her son. Well, her son was not only baptized as a Catholic, he became a priest. And not only was he a priest, but he became a bishop. And not only was he a bishop, but he became a saint. And so the story of Augustine's life, which is written in his Confessions, which is a great book to read, as I said yesterday, the Confessions of St. Augustine. In the Confessions, it shows you the path of conversion that this man took and how it developed and how it evolved and who influenced him and the mistakes that he made. He was living with a woman for many years. They had a son who also died before Augustine's conversion. And so it's even though he was in the 4th century, he's certainly a saint for the day. For us, those of us who struggle with life, those who struggle with articles of faith or whatever we might be struggling with internally, a man like Augustine can be certainly a great example for us as well. He had a particular phrase that he's most noted for, and he said that we have been made by God for him meaning God. God created us for himself. And so Augustine says, our hearts are restless until they rest in him. And I think that's so true in our human experience, that we are restless more at times than others, but we are not truly at peace until our heart rests in the Lord. And so that is our goal, I think, as Christians in this life. It's attainable, certainly in the next, but in this life. We can have a heart filled with the Lord if we open it and allow him to enter. May the Lord grant you this.